Video title appears, The CITES Framework.
In a school system, the decisions that one person makes can ripple across the entire district. For example, one decision by a single IT person can affect thousands of people in the district. So it's worthwhile to consider. Will the effects of a decision reduce barriers or create more barriers for the district's students? If you want to efficiently and effectively use technology to serve learning for all students, the CITES Framework is for you. The collaboration that the CITES Framework encourages can transform an entire system, from the district superintendent to the IT department to educators, direct service providers, and even the students and families served. The framework provides a plan for general education leaders and special education leaders to ensure collaborative decision-making that reduces barriers. After adopting the CITES Framework, we've seen things like EdTech and curriculum leaders building inclusive technology strategies into professional development for all staff, not just special educators. We've seen district leaders set a vision and plan for implementing inclusive technology as a part of the broad district mission, vision, and strategic plan, so that all staff recognize the importance of building equitable learning opportunities. And we've seen IT staff work with families to ensure access to their learners' accessible technologies at home and at school. The CITES Framework extends each of the five areas outlined in the 2017 National Educational Technology Plan: leadership, infrastructure, teaching, learning, and assessment, and provides evidence-based strategies districts can implement to make sure all students, especially those with disabilities, are supported. Let's take a look at each area of the CITES Framework. First, the leadership practices help leaders develop a plan to support a district-wide vision for inclusive technology. These practices help AT, EdTech, and IT departments that previously worked in isolation to plan collaboratively how to implement technology in the district. Also critical to the CITES Framework are the infrastructure practices. These practices help make sure that districts procure, implement, and manage inclusive devices and materials from the start. We've seen how one district went from zero procurement policies around accessibility to a policy that ensures all learning materials are, one, accessible and meet Section 508 requirements, and two, offer dynamic features for personalizing the learning experience. Then there's the teaching practices, which help educators use accessible technology tools in the learning experience that they are designing. So now a teacher might go to their digital learning specialist to learn more about how to use text-to-speech, so that they can empower a group of students to use it for themselves. The learning practices highlight the importance of focusing on students' agency to support their own learning. So instead of assuming kids know how to use a graphic organizer to collect their ideas for an essay, what we'd like to see is students having opportunities to learn how to use several different graphic organizers and then choosing the one that works best for them now and that they can take with them and continue using even after graduation. Then the assessment practices are interesting because we've seen a lot of changes to how we implement assessment over the last decade. These practices provide district leaders with a roadmap for developing comprehensive and balanced assessment systems that are inclusive and accessible. Finally, families need to be included in every aspect of planning and implementing inclusive technology systems. So the family engagement practices are streamlined across the entire framework. Districts that have embraced the practices in the CITES Framework have realized that making inclusive technology available to all students is just how business should be done. We encourage you to explore the CITES website, where you'll find lots of information on the areas of the framework, the practices, family engagement considerations, as well as self-assessments to guide your action planning. And be sure to also check out the case stories and short stories throughout the site. They will provide inspiration as you begin your journey. And always remember, the future is inclusive.
Text appears. To learn more, visit CITES.cast.org. The CITES logo appears. CITES, Center on Inclusive Technology and Education Systems. The CAST logo. CAST, until learning has no limits. Special thanks to Wellesley Public Schools, Massachusetts, Jenks Public Schools, Oklahoma, Mount Vernon Community School District, Iowa, Tom Ball Independent School District, Texas. The logo for the U.S. Office of Special Education Programs, Ideas That Work. This content was developed under a grant from the U.S. Department of Education, grant number H327T180001. However, the contents do not necessarily represent the policy of the U.S. Department of Education, and you should not assume endorsement by the federal government. Project Officer, Anita Vermeer, Master of Education. This video is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike 4.0 International License, 2023.